My name is Kieran Bowers, and I'm president of Swire Properties Inc. So I'll normally get up in the early hours of the morning, do a little bit of work, get my kids up, and then get them ready for school, get myself ready, and head to the office, try and get in before 8 o'clock, and then it's usually a day of meetings, followed by you know, some time to hash through the email box, and then head home, hopefully, if I get a chance, before bedtime. Doesn't always work out that way. 7 and 8 o'clock. Yeah, so I graduated from Oxford in 98, and at that time, I wasn't quite sort of sure what I was really going to, which avenue I was going to pursue. And, you know, the way the sort of universities work in the UK is that a number of industry-leading companies will come and talk to potential graduates. And a friend of mine told me that, you know, Swire would be there and there'd be an introduction, and I looked up their profile in the Career Centre and sort of thought it was interesting, very much an Asian bent on their activities. So I applied, joined in 1998, and then spent 10 years initially with the airline, Cathay Pacific, which Swire has a controlling interest in, and sort of had roles in a number of different countries as a result of that, in Pakistan and Saudi Arabia and Sri Lanka and Amsterdam and Hong Kong. And then after 10 years, the beauty of Swire is that under the umbrella of that organization, you can then move into a different part of the business. So I moved into the property side. And I've been with the property side for 10 years now also. So it's been 20 years, 10 in the airline, 10 in the property. We basically have a management a management team that covers graduates who've come from Hong Kong, from China, from the UK. And on that scheme, you go through various sort of checkpoints of development, both internally through our own kind of in-house Swire University, as it were, and also some external organizations like INSEAD. And then as you grow, the company will look at where your skill sets are and where the business, you know, is best suited to your skill set. So I had spent quite a bit of time in Beijing running a new development that we had up there, a retail development, mixed-use concept like this. And I think it was based on, you know, establishing that as a new center that sort of made my experience relevant, really, for what we've just opened here in Brickell City Centre in November. So I, you know, developed quite a bit of experience, I think, on the development side and on the retail side. Sort of crown and flagship really is still Pacific Place in Hong Kong. I think that's where we have our, you know, our origins as a mixed use developer. But more recently, I mean, some of the stuff we've been doing in China has been very well feted. Whether it's the center we have in Chengdu because of its sensitivity, being built on a sort of 1,000-year-old temple site with the temple old buildings integrated into it, or something that's a bit more edgy in the outskirts of Beijing, like Sanlitun. You know, we have lots of different. There's no singular model that we or cookie cutter that we just reproduce around the world. Each site will have a very different design and look and feel to it. That's a fundamental part of our design DNA, that we basically build large-scale mixed-use properties on major transport intersections. In China, Hong Kong, that's usually on some sort of subway interchange. It could be a single line, but quite often it's an intersection between two lines. And we facilitate connectivity from that hub into our development. So that kind of provides people with a seamless transition from, you know, wherever they come from, their home, through into the public area and then up into the office, which is, you know, a component or the retail. So that's what we've also tried to replicate here in Brickell when we've integrated the Metro Mover station. We would like public transport to be seamlessly integrated into what we do. Yeah. So the research we've done so far indicates that the Brickell market is a much younger market. It's a very affluent market compared to some of the other suburban areas which have retail centres. It obviously has a very urban feel to it. So, you know, the demands of the urban, where we look normally at sort of fashion, there'll be a big workwear component required. Quite a lot more in sort of services and facilities. So I think we're sort of seeing a sort of young sub-40s group that Some have kids, some don't, but it's really that kind of demographic that that seems to be the biggest frequenter of the property. I mean, national chains like Apple or Zara or Victoria's Secret, I mean, I think they make up around 40-50%. Then you've got a selection of more localized concepts, Casa Tua, for example, or La Centrale, the Italian food hall. I mean, they're very one-off experiences that are only at Brickell City Centre, including Cinemex, the cinema as well. I would guess that's probably another sort of 20-something percent. And then what we've tried to do is we've tried to bring a cluster of new-to-market concepts from Europe, from South America. In terms of total number of shops, it's probably about 15, 20 shops. And that's to try and provoke a little more interest and curiosity and surprise that people won't really have come across these concepts before. Not specifically, no. I mean, it's hard to kind of gauge. What we do know and what was released sort of last year is that Brickell City Centre is in the top 10 of destinations in Florida for Uber and the top 5 for Miami. So we can't really tell roughly where these people are coming. We can do intercept surveys, but again, it really depends what time of year, what day of the week you're doing it. I mean, I think, you know, looking at the profile of our consumer, we've probably got about 50%, 60% who are Miami-based residents. And then I think the remainder is probably a chunk of tourism and then short-term visitors. Yeah, there's always surprises. I mean, I think probably the age of our demographic and some of the success that we've had in the stores. You know, initially, I think putting a retail concept in a downtown urban environment was, and across three city blocks, was going to be quite sort of avant-garde and revolutionary at its time. I mean, the city of Miami hasn't seen a retail center for probably 10, 15 years. And so introducing these concepts in this environment and understanding how now people tend to consume, that people don't generally want to get in a car and head out to different areas. They want it to be on their doorstep. I think in combination with what we've introduced on the F&B side, which has really resonated with a sort of more, you know, I would say millennial type generation, much more casual eateries, very, very sort of different types of seating, much more lively sort of atmosphere, an upbeat atmosphere, has really been a strong point, I think, of what we've offered in the centre.